Chairman, I just want to thank you again for your bipartisanship. I was on the floor yesterday with Congressman Levin debating six bills that we passed on suspension dealing with human rights and Burma and genocide, and it just makes me proud to be a part of this committee. And today, we're going to mark up two bipartisan bills and five bipartisan resolutions. And I want to start by thanking you, Chairman Engel, for your work on House Resolution 517, supporting the Global Fund, which I'm proud to be the lead Republican on this effort. It's vitally important, as you mentioned. The cuts were unacceptable. I think you and I standing together to fully fund this Global Health Fund right now in the United Nations is the assembly is in New York right now, and there will be a global health conference in Lyon, France in October. I think this important piece of legislation will send a strong message to the world that we intend to fully fund it, and we also want full participation from other countries. Today, we will consider three very important Hong Kong measures. Last week, I was proud to have joined Speaker Pelosi and you, sir, and Mr. Engel, Congressman Smith, the author of the bill, and Jim McGovern, and several Hong Kong pro-democracy activists to denounce China's authoritarian brutality. I said it then, I'll say it again. Today, we stand not as Republicans or Democrats, but as Americans united in our strong support for Hong Kong. And as I said at the press conference, directly to the people of Hong Kong, America stands with you, and we will always support you. We hear you sing our national anthem, and we see you carrying our American flag. This is a battle between democracy versus dictatorship, liberty versus tyranny, and freedom versus oppression. I'm pleased that today we will consider Mr. Smith's Hong Kong Human Rights and Democracy Act, which sends a clear message to China that there will be consequences to their ruthless and brutal actions. This committee, this Congress, and the United States and the world will not stand by idly as the Chinese Communist Party fights for itself and not its own people. I know we read many reports coming out of China after our press conference, and I'm sure we'll hear many today. I wear that as a badge of honor. I would also like to highlight House Resolution 521, which I introduced with my good friend Chairman Engel. This resolution commends Canada for upholding the rule of law regarding the extradition of Huawei Technologies Chief Financial Officer Meng Wanzhou. It also expresses concern with China's retaliatory and hostile actions against Canadian citizens detained in China. China's hostage diplomacy is abhorrent. Canadian citizens Michael Kovreg and Michael Spavar have been detained in China since last year without due process and have been subjected to harsh conditions such as limited consular access, no attorney representation, and lengthy interrogations. Meanwhile, Ms. Meng, on the other hand, has received proper treatment in Canadian custody, with all of her legal health and other needs attended to, and is currently released on bail. What a difference in the two criminal justice systems. I commend Canada and regret that the Canadian citizens are paying the price of China's malfeasance. Canadian citizens must be released immediately. Finally, we all need to remember that Huawei is supported by the Chinese government and is responsive to its leaders. Our data is not safe or secure on their systems. And I appreciate Australia, and I was at the embassy last weekend with the Prime Minister and other countries who have pushed back against Huawei. So, Mr. Chairman, I look forward to supporting you and these measures today, and I yield back the balance of my time.